Hi, do you see any of these smartwatches? Is good enough for heart rate measurements while training? Or is it worth buying a separate chest strap? How accurate are each of them? How do smartwatches compare to chest strap for heart rate monitoring? In this video, I measure the accuracy of different smartwatches, optical armbands and low-cost chest straps, both for outdoor and indoor cycling. First, I will explain how I have tested the watch in order to measure accuracy, and then we'll discuss individual results for the Garmin Fenix 5, Polar M600, Samsung Galaxy Watch 4, Samsung Galaxy Watch 5, Google Pixel Watch, Montblanc Summit 3 Watch, Fitcare HW702, Wahoo TickR Fit and Coospo H6. All the watches which are on the list are able to broadcast to any cycling head unit either natively or through our app HRQVP that we developed at BIPR. I tested the accuracy of heart rate measurements both outdoor and indoor. Before each ride, I checked these different points which are important if you want to get the best accuracy. I cleaned the sensor with water. I put the watch on the wrist, not too close to the hand. There should be about 2 fingers in between, and I had a look at the battery. The watch should be charged enough. As I have a scientific background, I want to give you the conditions in which I did my tests. If you want to skip this part, you can access individual results or conclusions directly with chapters in the description. For every outdoor ride, I use my road bike on the same route and rode at the same pace. The ride is 22 kilometers, around 45 minutes. The first 6 kilometers are warm up, then there is a 3 kilometer hill, around 6 minutes, a bit over the functional threshold power, which is the average power I can hold for an hour. At the top, I checked my heart rate, around 180. Then 20 minutes tempo, and finally the last uphill with 2 to 3 minutes close to anaerobic threshold and heart rate above 180. I describe the test because I must say that this is really challenging. You have big heart rate variations during the ride, and just before the last climb there is a downhill with a speed above 50 km per hour and with a high tension on the wrists. But this is usually the way I ride my bike, so this is challenging but representative. Before I give you the results, I must tell you my definition of accuracy. In order to compute the accuracy in percent, I first get the standard deviation between the heart rate measured by the watch and the heart rate measured by my Polar H10 chest strap, which is known as one of the most accurate on the market. And then, I make the division of this standard deviation value by the average heart rate measured by the Polar H10. Now, let's see the results, starting with the oldest watches. The first watch I tested is the Polar M600. The heart rate of the watch is in red and the Polar H10 in blue. As you can see on the graph, it takes a huge amount of time to match with the H10, but then it does very well for the next 20 minutes. And finally, in the downhill, it doesn't fall as fast as the H10 and has some trouble in the last uphill. The overall accuracy is 23%. This watch can make good measurements but has a lot of inertia. For long rides at almost constant pace, this watch might be good. I don't have the graph here for indoor, but it takes a lot of time to go up at the beginning as well. And then everything was fine. The second watch on the list is the Garmin Fenix 5. I am sorry, but here outdoor the results are awful. You have 30% difference with the H10. The heart rate never matches. What I think is that I have a small wrist and the watch is big. Maybe this is the reason why it is so inaccurate. The size of the watch is something you need to consider before buying. Indoor, the watch catches up with the H10 on small sections, where the heart rate is very low, but otherwise it's almost always off. The Fenix 5 is a very nice watch. You can pair many sensors, power meters, cadence sensor, the battery life is awesome, but definitely I wouldn't use it for heart rate measurements. Then I tested the Samsung Galaxy Watch 4. The accuracy outdoor is nearly the same as the Fenix 5 at 31%. The watch is in trouble and sometimes you get the same value during 5 minutes, for example here. I wouldn't recommend to use this watch for heart rate monitoring while training outdoor. If you use it personally, let me know in the comments if you get better results, but here it doesn't work well. I had the impression that starting an activity with Samsung Health in parallel makes the watch switch into more active for sport and the results may be better. I will do further tests about this point in the future. Indoor accuracy is a bit better, but still not perfect at 21%. The Galaxy Watch 4 is in orange and the Galaxy Watch 5 in red. As you can see, the Galaxy Watch 5 did a perfect job with an accuracy of, listen, 1.5%. The performance of the watch is at very high level indoor, which makes it suitable for bike training. Outdoor, however, the result is nearly the same as with the Watch 4 with 30% accuracy. It seems that the watch is very sensitive to vibrations. You get the same issues with underestimations and freezing. Let's move on to the Summit 3 watch, which is much more expensive. It is a luxury good at $1,260. Accuracy is a bit better at 18%, but still not perfect and still not consistent enough. The watch is able to catch up with the H10, and then both curves are very close, but there are two big drop-off. Indoor, however, the watch did a very nice job and gets an accuracy of 2%, which is very good and nearly as good as the Galaxy Watch 5. The last wearless watch I have tested is the Pixel watch. I already did a full review about the watch. Outdoor, the accuracy is 13%. You get big differences at the beginning and for high intensity intervals, for example here, where I get close to 180 with the H10 and the Pixel stays around 150. Indoor, the results are really good. The accuracy is 3%. It only takes the watch 3 to 5 minutes to get correct measurements and catch up with the H10. Now, let's have a look at optical armbands. Here are the results for the Fitcare HW702, which is around 4 years old. It is better than any other smartwatch, I think, because measurements on the arm are less exposed to vibration than on the wrist, especially on the road bike where you have high pressure in the tire with almost direct transmission to the hands. You can see that there is a lag between the band and the chest strap. It takes some time for the band to increase or decrease, especially at the beginning. It takes the band 8 minutes to match with the H10. The accuracy here is 9%. Indoor, at the beginning, the HW702 needs 5 minutes to catch up, and then there was a big drop during the first interval. Even for the second interval here, it drops off when HR gets too high. The overall accuracy is 29% due to this drop. The more recent Wahoo TickR Fit gets better results with an accuracy of 7%. But again, you have some lag, especially at the beginning, and the bands tend to underestimate heart rate at high intensity levels, for example here around 180 when I was close to my max. indoor, the results are very good. The band is more consistent than the Fitcare HW702, only here around 180, where you can see 5 to 10 bit difference. The accuracy here is measured at 2%, which is really good. I think this heart rate monitor is good enough to be used for serious training. And last but not least, I wanted to see how does a cheaper chest strap compared to the Polar H10. Here, this is the Coospo H6, which costs around 25 bucks. The result is not perfect. You have small differences, but overall, it is much better than any smartwatch and a bit better than the TickR Fit. After 20 minutes, then I was fully warmed up, and both straps give exactly the same result on the last part of the ride. The accuracy here was around 6%. There is no lag, which is very interesting, for example, in order to estimate power with our app HR2VP. Indoor, the results are perfect. When you are indoor, you sweat more, and straps need some moisture to measure heart rate correctly. This confirms that when fully warmed up, with a little bit of sweat, you get same values as the H10. Here, the accuracy is 0.5%, which is outstanding. Whoa! This was a big amount of data. Now, let's give you my personal conclusions. All these tests made it obvious to me that there are big differences between devices. The overall trend is that more recent devices tend to be better, but even between recent devices, there are big differences. This means that the technology is getting better and better. Now, which device is the right for you? Well, to my opinion, it depends on what you want to do. But let's say first, you train mostly indoor. Here is an overview of all indoor results. You can see the accuracy in percent. Of course, lower means better. I think recent devices such as the Galaxy Watch 5, Pixel Watch or Summit 3 are good, even for occasional outdoor riding or for fitness purposes. They will be perfectly fine for serious training indoor, even for power estimation based on heart rate with our app HR2VP. This means that you can use your watch to ride on Zwift on any spin bike without any sensor on the bike. I think I will make a video soon about this topic. Now, let's say you mainly ride outdoor. In this case, if you want to use heart rate as a training metric, or if you want to estimate power, I would get a chest strap for better consistency. If you have a low budget, you can buy the Coospo H6. There is an affiliate link in the description. If you want a higher-end device, choose the Polar H10 or any other strap from big brands. And if you don't like chest straps, armbands such as the TickR Fit are fine. Or get the Pixel Watch, which has the best results. Now, I would like to know what is your experience with smartwatches and heart rate measurements. Feel free to leave a comment or ask any question below. Thanks for watching and see you soon. Bye bye!